Pioneer Tom Means persuaded Roy Elwood and Frank Wiseman to help him dig near the Kern River, Bakersfield. At only 70 feet down, they hit what they were looking for: oil. 2 billion barrels later, Kern River is now the third largest oil field in California. A 250,000 oil wells followed their first dig, and more than 78,000 of them are still actively producing today. But every single one is a potential methane leak source. Even managed wells are expected to emit small volumes of greenhouse gases during the extraction process. But in one of the most sustainable states in North America, you would expect those emissions to be minimal. Well, that's what the Aerospace Corporation's Karen Jones thought before a turboprop plane installed with an advanced hyperspectral imaging sensor flew over the region, mapping methane emissions. Karen and the aerospace team were shocked by the number and size of the methane plumes billowing from the wells. The imaging sensor indicated that some of the operating wells were leaking emissions at flow rates 200,000% above the Environmental Protection Agency's average estimate for Western US gas wells. Not surprisingly, the California Department of Health classified the Bakersfield Air District as severe non-attainment, meaning it doesn't meet federal ground-level ozone and particulate matter standards. After meeting investigative reporter Kiara Eisner at a conference in Norway, Karen elaborated on what her team had found. Kiara suspected that what Karen had observed in Bakersfield was likely to be happening across the US, so she dug deeper. After months of research and interviews, Kiara started to uncover the extent of the problem. It was, in fact, far worse than the government had estimated, and was disproportionately endangering the lives of those who lived near the oil and gas sites. After almost a year of reporting, Scientific American, part of Springer Nature, published the article Kiara wrote. The impact was immediate and prompted an oil and gas producer to look at their equipment and check if they had any leaks. We know that these methane leaks are not good for our planet or the oil industry, but finding them is challenging. Current tools and technologies are simply not efficient when sites have countless wells and hundreds, if not thousands, of miles of pipelines to monitor. It's very much a needle in a haystack situation. But the winds are changing. At COP26, US President Biden unveiled a pledge not only to reinstate the EPA methane emissions rule that his predecessor had repealed, but also to slash current global methane emissions by 30% before 2030. Airborne and space-based imaging sensors and monitoring will provide the coverage that's required, and the commercial space industry is now taking the lead to identify methane leaks all over the planet. A Canadian company, GHGSat, has already launched and is operating 2 methane hunting satellites, with plans to expand their constellation this year. Additionally, the Environmental Defense Fund plans to launch MethaneSat, its mission being to collect unprecedented and publicly accessible data on the changing methane emissions across our planet. With nowhere for methane to hide, the question is, how can these new eye-in-the-sky tools work with regulators and industries to deliver the important methane reductions our world needs? Springer Nature publications like Scientific American and Nature Geoscience will continue to keep the spotlight on these developments. Watch this space.